Hey guys, how's it going? Hope you're having an awesome day. Happy Canada Day for those of you who were celebrating Canada a couple days ago. Here we are in July already. It's summer, it's getting hot, it's getting sizzling out there. And it's time for some Maluma, I think. Some Latin pop, and if you watched my previous video where I listened to Anita for the first time, I had a huge blast listening to that album. It was the first Latin pop record I had ever listened to in whole before. So now I'm going to continue on with this Latin pop trend I'm doing. Maluma, I had never heard of Maluma before, believe it or not. Up until I heard Medellin by Madonna, he was featured in that song. Even to this day, I've still not heard a full Maluma song, let alone a full Maluma record. So I'm so excited to finally listen to him for the first time. I'm obsessed with Latin pop right now. Anyway, there are 16 tracks on this record. I have not heard a single track on this record. So let's get into it. Track number one, 11 p.m. Una en la mañana todavía no hay respuesta. Cómo hacerte entender que conmigo tú te ves mejor, que en mi carro tú te ves mejor. El cuento huele a Christian Dior. Eres muy bonita para llorar por él. Cómo hacerte entender que conmigo tú te ves mejor, que en mi carro tú te ves mejor. Dice que está ocupado en cosas más importantes. La nube que no deja ver el sol brillar. 11 de la noche todavía no contesta. Una de la mañana todavía no hay respuesta. 3 de la mañana yo te tengo una propuesta. ¿Cómo hacerte entender que conmigo tú te ves mejor? Okay, so that was track number one, 11 p.m. And I will say, I don't know any Spanish, so I don't know what he's singing about. But Spanish, it's a very beautiful language, and I want to learn it one day, honestly. Rosetta Stone. But anyway, so that was track number one. It was a good song. It's Maluma. I imagine this album's gonna be chock full of really sexy songs. And I think I forgot to mention in the introduction. I cannot talk sometimes. In the introduction of this video, I think I failed to mention that the album I'm listening to is 1111. I forget if I mentioned that or not, but I mentioned it now to you guys. Anyway, enough talking. Let's get into track number two, HP. Okay, so that was track number two, HP, and I will say that I'm listening to this album on Apple Music, and every time you listen to an album on here, usually the top songs on the album have a little star beside them. So I imagine the ones with the star are the most popular, they're the ones that are downloaded the most, they're typically the singles. So the ones with the little stars beside the titles are 11 p.m. and HP. So I imagine these are the most popular songs on the record. And HP, really sexy song. Again, I have no idea what he's singing about. He could be singing about murder for all I know. But you know what? It's sexy because it's Maluma. He's singing it. So he could honestly sing the phone book and it would be sexy. Does anybody even use phone books anymore? No. Anyway. So that was HP, another good song. Honestly, these songs, even though I don't know what he is necessarily talking about or singing about, I'm just, you know, moving my body. I'm just letting my body do the talking, honestly. So now let's move on to track number 3, No Se Me Quita. Is that how you say it? I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry if I butcher some of the pronunciations of these words. Like I said, I don't know Spanish. It's featuring Ricky Martin. Yes. Enough said. Okay, so that was track number 3, No Se Me Quita, featuring Ricky Martin, and this is probably my favorite track on the record so far. A lot of fun, I really enjoyed it, and it's Ricky Martin, come on, ugh. So now let's move right along to track number 4, Dispuesto, featuring Ozuna. So sexy. So that was track number 4, Dispuesto, and this is again one of my favorite songs on the record so far. It's tied with No Se Me Quita. Yeah, I mean, I feel like I'm not gonna have anything negative to say about this album. There might be a couple tracks I probably won't like, obviously. I mean, we don't usually like all the songs on the record, let's be honest. But I'm digging these songs so far. Again, they're just so fun to dance to. I'm not properly dancing right now. I'm just sitting on my little yoga ball right now, bouncing up and down. But I can imagine if it's like an actual public setting, a gathering of such, and there's loud music playing. I mean, I can obviously properly dance better. I mean, I can't even talk right now. I'm having so much fun. Okay, anyway, let's move on to track number 5. Oh, no, I don't know how to pronounce that. I need to look it up. Ugh. Okay, so now let's move on to track number 5. No puedo olvidarte, featuring Nicki Jam. Yo solo aquí en mi cama, pensando lo que te haría, qué pasaría si tú me llamas. Sé que te di olvidar el sabor de tu boca. Yeah. Slow's track number 5, No Puedo Olvidarte. Oh my god. Okay, I'm having a lot of fun, as you can see. Nothing bad to say about that song. Really enjoyable. I had fun listening to it. Really cool. I've enjoyed this album so far, as you can see. So that was that. So now let's move on to track number 6. I don't know how to pronounce that. I will say though, there have been a few times where I thought I needed to find out how to pronounce a certain word, so I kind of typed it into Google, and sometimes I'm actually right, so sometimes I should really trust my judgment when it comes to pronouncing some of these words, because I feel like I nail it sometimes. I just want to be sure. Okay, so moving right along, we are at track number 6, Mi Enamor de Ti. Did I pronounce that right? Please let me know. Okay, so that was track number 6, and I gotta say, these songs are, you know, they're bops. I will say, they are, you know, they're really good, and I'm having fun. I'm gonna say this multiple times throughout this video. I'm having fun, and to me, that's what music is. It's having fun, and I'm enjoying myself. Maluma, yes, definitely A+. I am loving him so far. Okay, so let's move right along to track number 7. Extradon Dote, and I probably mispronounced it. I'm so sorry. I tried to look up how to pronounce this word and I couldn't find anything, so I tried my best. Featuring Zion and Lennox.
Y sin regresar, ¿dónde estás? Lleva a estar extrañándote, pero no tanto. No, yo sigo aquí, pensando en ti.
Para buscaría por todo el mundo tus labios. Es que está lo tan rico que mi aniversario necesita.
Okay, so that was track number 7, and probably one of my favorite songs on the record so far. Honestly, this was so much fun. Again, I use the word fun, but honestly, every single one of these songs is fun. This song extra non dolce. Again, I probably mispronounced that. I'm so sorry. My favorite song, well, not my favorite, one of my favorite songs on the record so far. My favorite song on the record so far is probably, I don't really know. Honestly, a lot of them are just so good. You know what? Maybe I'll say this is my favorite song so far. Why not? So anyway, let's move on to track number 8. Shh. Kala. Okay, so that was track number 8, Shkala. Really enjoyable. I enjoyed the song a lot. Really groovy, good melody, good beat. Yeah, I had a lot to listen to it. Okay, so moving right along to track number 9, Dinero Tiene Cuquera. Okay, so that was track number 9, Dinero Tiene Cuquera, and that, obviously it's a ballad, and it's probably not my favorite track on the record, but it's definitely not my least favorite. It's a good song, it's just not one of my favorites, but it was a nice little ballad, I enjoyed listening to it. So now let's move on to track number 10, Soltera featuring the one and only, she doesn't need any introduction, the Queen Madonna.
Soltera, nadie la enamora. sabes bien cuál es el movimiento. No te sientes, sube la mano, se mueve tu cuerpo. Tú sabes bien cuál es el movimiento. Dale pa' atrás, pa' atrás, pa' atrás.
And don't you forget it.
And don't you forget it.
Chao, papi. And don't you forget it. Chao, papi. You're going to regret it. Yeah, chao, papi. Bye, bye, bye.
Okay, so that was track number 10, Soltera featuring, oh my voice just cracked there, featuring Madonna. Good song, very sassy, very, you know, in your face. I like that. It's typical Madonna, and she did this song justice. Really enjoyable. Probably, to me, one of the highlights on the album. And now let's move right along to track number 11, Te Quiero. So much fun, awesome song, probably one of my favorites on the record. I mean, I had a lot of fun grooving to the song, as you can see. Te Quiero, really good song. Oh my god, I enjoyed it so much. Really, 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 really good. Okay, now let's move on to track number 12. I'm gonna try pronouncing this title without looking it up first. Let's see how bad I can butcher it. Instinto Natural featuring, I don't know their name. Okay, I have to look it up. I'm so sorry. And for those of you who do know Spanish, I hope you're having your fill and laughing at me right now, because I am pathetic when it comes to pronouncing other languages. This is what Maluma does to me. Oh, I'm so thirsty. Okay, so let's move right along to track number 12, Instinto Natural featuring Sach.
Miedo a perderte, aunque la calle quiero verte.
Okay, so that was track number 12. It's Instinto Natural, and it's unfortunately not one of my favorite tracks on the record. It's probably one of my least favorite. This is a song I would probably skip over. I don't want to say that, but unfortunately, I just wasn't really feeling this song. It was good, but it wasn't something I would really listen to again. But anyway, let's move on to track number 13. Tu Fisida featuring Ty Dolla Sign.
You ain't been screaming, baby. I used to bang, 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 down in the day.
Okay, so that was track number 13, 2-2-2-2-2-2-2, Fisida. Really good song, I enjoyed it. Very catchy with that 2-2-2-2-2-2. Really good, I enjoyed it. Featuring Ty Dolla Sign, so good song, I enjoyed it. Alrighty, so let's move right along to track number 14, La Faca featuring Chencho Corleone. Number 14, La Flaca. And again, this isn't probably one of my favorite tracks on the record. It was kind of in between for me. To me, it wasn't the greatest song. It was okay. Would I listen to again? If it came up on shuffle, I might. But it's not a song I would really go to if I was to pull up 1111 by Maluma. But we only have two tracks left, guys. Track number 15, Puesto Pa' Ti.
Estoy afuera, sal. Tengo un par de cosas que te quiero explicar. Y ahora todo es un mal. Y si es para nadie, sigo afuera aquí explicando. Tú sigues ignorándome. Dicen tus amigas y te la pasas llorando. Ya estoy puesto para ti.
Pistols track number 50, Puesto Pa' Ti. And I wasn't sure about the song when I first started listening to it. I was like, yeah, this is a good song, it's all right. But then about halfway through, I was like, you know what? I'm feeling this song, I'm digging it, I'm liking it. So by the end of it, you know what? I enjoyed it. Is it one of my favorite tracks? No. But you know, it's a decent song, I enjoy listening to it. But we have made it to the end, guys. It is the finale of the album. A little sad. Track number 16, Jelly Saber. And it's a little sad because oddly enough, there are 16 tracks on this record. And it could have been longer, honestly. Let's be real, it's Maluma. But sadly, it does have to come to an end. So let's get into it. Track number 16.
Siempre te maltrata, te usa, te abusa porque te usa porque tiene plata. No, no, sácalo de tu vida. Déjale saber que ahora tú eres mía.
Okay guys, so that is 11-11 by Maluma. And for my first Maluma record ever, my first time ever listening to a solo Maluma album or song before, I was fairly surprised, and I really enjoyed it. It was a lot of fun. Again, Latin pop for me is a whole new world, and I haven't listened to any Latin pop really until Madonna's Madam X album, and then I listened to Anita, and here I am at Maluma. Really excited, and I want to continue my journey on with Latin pop. I might not release another Latin pop first listen right away. There's still so many albums out there I want to get into, but I will definitely continue listening to Latin pop, and I'll continue recording and uploading Latin pop first listens in the future. There's also K-pop, and there's also, I don't know, there's just so many albums I haven't heard yet, and I feel like with each album I listen to, I'm getting more familiar with different sounds and different melodies and different everything when it comes to music, and I feel like my eyes and ears are opening to so many different things the more music I consume and the different varieties of music I consume. So thanks for watching, guys. Leave a comment. Tell me what your favorite Maluma song is. Tell me if you have ever seen him live before, if you're a huge fan. What other Latin pop record should I listen to? What other Latin pop artist should I listen to? What artist in general should I be listening to? They don't have to necessarily have to be Latin pop. They could be any artist that I might not know of, or some albums you want to be listened to. They could be like mainstream ones from like popular artists, I really don't care. They could be from this decade, they could be from the 1970s, the 1960s, the 1980s, 90s, rock, pop, country, jazz, blues, rap, R&B, anything. Honestly, I'm open to anything. So thanks for watching, guys. You can find me on Instagram, Twitter, leave a comment, leave a message, do whatever you want. You can also find me at Apple Music. You can listen to my playlist and what I'm listening to right now. Yeah, so check it out. And thanks for watching, guys. I had a lot of fun, and hopefully you did too. So thanks for watching. Take care. Bye.